Good morning. Good morning, St. Andrews. Good morning. Good morning, St. Andrews. Good morning, parents and visitors to St. Andrews. My name's Frank Clark and I'm the Director of Faith, Mission and Learning here at the College. And it gives me great pleasure on behalf of our College Principal, Dr. Stephen Knorr, to welcome you here this morning to our St. Andrews College Year 7 to 11 presentation of awards and prize giving for the academic year 2021. We say hello to people who are viewing with this as it's being live streamed at home, very proud family and friends I'm sure, and kept as a recording for posterity. Our Assistant Principal for Teaching and Learning, Mrs. Michelle Deschamps, will be our Master of Ceremonies today, and my role is to commence with our acknowledgement of country and our liturgy this morning. Thank you for the respect that you have shown and adhering to current COVID regulations by wearing your masks at all times whilst inside. Could we please ensure that our mobile phones are switched to silent or turned off? We are reminded that unfortunately we cannot sing as a congregation today due to current regulations. I call upon our college captains for 2022, Hayley O'Connor and Wasim Farah, to acknowledge the country on which we gather as Aboriginal land.
I would like to begin by acknowledging the Darug people, the traditional custodians of the land on which we gather today, and pay our respects to their elders, past and present. We also acknowledge traditional custodians of country throughout Australia and their connections to land, sea, and community.
We pay our respect to the Aboriginal elders, past, present, and future, for they hold the traditions, memories, and wisdom of Mother Earth on which we place our feet upon today. We extend that respect to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people present today.
Thank you, Hayley and Wasim. It's my pleasure to welcome this morning Father Kevin Redmond, one of the new Marist fathers in our parish, to lead us in our liturgy this morning. You're very welcome, Father Kevin.
So we make the sign of the cross together as we pray in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. This morning we have much to be thankful for in what has been a difficult year for all, yet perseverance and the grace of God have got us to this point to celebrate the achievements of St. Andrew's College student community and their hard-working teachers and staff, and we celebrate with their family and their friends. And so we pray, God of hope, be with us in our Advent journey to the stable and beyond. Be with us in our meeting and in our travelling together. Be with us as we celebrate our achievements this year. Be with us in our worship and our praying together. Be with us in our joy as this school year draws to a close. Bless us with a gracious heart as we thank all the members of our college community who have journeyed with us this year. May your grace fill each of us with joy as we make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. In that prayer we mentioned joy, and there's a famous hymn called Joy to the World. And so we gather to celebrate the achievements of the very talented students here at St. Andrew's College and the hard work of so many who have contributed to this success. And we gather as we approach Christmas, a time when we truly can acknowledge Jesus as joy to the world. I won't ask for a show of hands, but some of you may know that Joy to the World, the Christmas classic, was written in the early 18th century by Isaac Watts. But did you realise that one of the most famous Christmas carols was almost written by accident? Isaac Watts did not write Joy to the World as a Christmas carol, but as a translation from the psalm, one of the psalms in the Hebrew scriptures. In 1719, Watts published a book of poems in which each poem was based on a psalm. But rather than just translate the original Old Testament texts, he adjusted them to refer more explicitly to the work of Jesus as it had been revealed in the New Testament. Only later were these words put to music. Isn't it amazing and so wonderful to think that the great joy to the world of God becoming human through the infant Jesus was to be found in texts centuries older? This morning we shall hear our very talented students and staff musicians lift their hearts in song as they sing Joy to the World. Gracious God, we ask your blessing upon these young women and men who we honour today for their achievements. We celebrate their capacity for creativity, for critical thinking, for focused effort. We are grateful that they and their families entrusted our St Andrew's College teachers and staff to engage them intellectually, morally and spiritually. Thank you for all our students' confidence to discover and explore new possibilities and knowledge to discern what is right and good and just in our world. Enable them to draw upon the wisdom and experience of yesterday as they respond to the questions and concerns of tomorrow. Support our honoured student leaders as they continue to make a difference in the world and lead a life for the greater glory of God. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And for a final blessing, I offer this Christmas blessing as we enter a joyous season of anticipation and hope for the birth of the Lord. The Lord be with you. May you be encouraged in your faith as you wait for the birth of Christ. May the Lord deepen your love for others and give you the courage to walk in the light of truth and happiness. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his face upon you and give you peace. And may the light of this Advent season bring you the happiness and hope that God desires for you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go now in peace and in knowledge that we are strengthened by our God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you very much, Father Kevin, for leading us this morning in our prayer, and thank you to our musicians for sharing their talent. We will now hear from them with Rocking Around the Christmas Tree, and at the end of that, Mrs. Michelle Deschamps will lead us for this morning's ceremony.
Thank you. Good morning and welcome to our special guests today, Captain Terry Morrison and Father Redman, parents, the College Principal Dr. Knorr, the leadership team, leaders of learning, staff and students to St Andrew's College Years 7 to 11 presentation ceremony. Before we start the proceedings today, I'd like to remind you again about the mobile phones being switched off or onto silent for the remainder of the evening. And in the spirit of the community and the consideration to others, that parents and students remain until the conclusion of the awards ceremony. Please hold your applause until the end of each section of awards. Out of respect and pride for our wonderful country, we will commence by playing the national anthem. Awards ceremony this morning, could I please invite Dr. Knorr to the stage to address the Assembly.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen, award recipients from Years 7 to 11, members of the College Leadership Team, staff, family and friends viewing from home, to our special guests, Captain Terry Morrison and Father Kevin, and hopefully we'll be joined a little bit later by the Honourable Ed Husick, Federal Member for Chifley. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the many people who have helped to make the Liturgy and the Academic Assembly come to life today. To Mr. Clark, Mrs. Deschamps, Mrs. Welsh, Ms. McKechnie, our Year 11 and 7 Leaders of Learning and Leaders of Wellbeing, Mrs. Cooper, Mrs. Potts, and our IT team for the organisation of today. There were times when we didn't think it was even going to happen due to the restrictions in place and the changing nature of health orders. So to see you all here today is such a blessing. To our dedicated staff, thank you for the hard work and support, encouragement, and the development of our young men and women in front of us today. Our Year 11 Awards Assembly is an opportunity to celebrate the hard work and achievements of staff, students, and their families. The spiritual, physical, intellectual, relational, and emotional growth in every student is what we strive to achieve at St Andrew's College. It's interesting to note that this is not the focus of society in general, the media, and indeed many schools. It's most likely due to an orientation towards hedonic tendency and instant gratification. They are fast becoming the norm. We see intelligent people acting with selfish attitude and motive. We see a lack of integrity with how people behave. My challenge to each one of us today is to contribute as intelligent young men and women with a moral purpose, with a faith, and with a positive attitude in life. It is most important to be honest with oneself. Our world needs smart people that are also good people. Your attitude and behaviour is always your choice. You have been formed in the image and likeness of God. do yourself, your family and your school proud by always doing more and going beyond. Never lose sight of the fact that life is not easy, but it's always an adventure and there are always opportunities. So we celebrate today many awards for hard work, for good works and for talent. It gives me great pride and hope, though, when I see so many awards with perfect attendance and also so many principals' awards. We introduced the principal award pin in 2020, and only 6 students in 2020 received that award. In 2021, 9 students received the principal's award pin at the Year 12 graduation last Monday. So we only have 15 people in our whole school who have received this recognition. At today's prize giving, there are another 13 students receiving this pin, and one student is receiving a second pin for the third principal's award that they've achieved. At the end of 2021, 29 students only would have received this recognition. And I believe having perfect attendance and receiving merits that go towards a principal's award demonstrates that firm foundation that we always talk about and that I always ask students to strive towards at assemblies. I was reflecting on that firm foundation recently and came across some wise words from Pope Francis that I will conclude with today. And his advice was to fellow preachers, and I'll make sure that I stick to this. The first one was, be brief, be bold, and be gone. The second, don't be afraid to be funny. The third, don't blame the Holy Spirit for your lack of preparation. And the fourth, be a human being. Our true path to God is being ourselves. God bless you all. Congratulations on your achievements this year. And may you and your families have a safe, happy, and holy Christmas.
Could the students in Group A awards please line up ready? Today we celebrate the achievements of our fine students. The awards that will be presented include representative awards, school awards, academic awards, and principals awards. Could I please ask Mrs. Cooper to the stage to announce the first awards?
Good morning, parents, special guests and students. Our first awards this morning are our Principal's Awards. To receive one Principal's Award, you receive a plaque. And the majority of our students this morning are receiving that plaque, and it's a big deal to receive a Principal's Award. I would like to invite Dr. Knorr to come to the stage to present our Principal's Awards. In Year 8, Daniel Birchmore. Raiden de Guzman. Suwanthi Edarasinghe. Ria Kumar. Lexi Marasigan. Charlene San Pedro. Seth Watkins. Can we please congratulate our Year 8 Principal Award winners for 2021? In Year 9, Jennifer Assey. Kate Astillo. Joycey Bacalod. Michaela Ballaballo. Alana Bautista. Janelle Calangeo. Chelsea Nicole Craig. Gabriel Chavez. Jazz Delapaz. Jeremy Delfino. Jeremy Fronteras. Tyrone Galaxidis. Chloe Garcia. Milton Giolamis. Alyssa Guillermo. Adia Hegde. Talina Hurani. Kyan Landrigan. Alana Lekoff. Andrea Leo. Jelaine Magayaga. Athu Majok. Holly McLaughlin. Ava Mulroney. Abe Negra. Isabella Narayan. Daniel Nusifora. Zachary Obsemia. Saran Papazian. Monarch Patel. Esther Peter. Nathaniel Predescu. Akshita Rabadia. Jeremy Sabadin. Joshua Samet. Erona Sengalang. Angelo Sayers. Patricia Toison. Dominic Watson. Joe Zhu. Please congratulate our Year 9 Principal Award winners. I invite, I'll just wait for a photo. Thank you, Year 9. For Year 10, Hannah Ajay. Ava Ali. Drew Beattie. Jaden Kesser. Jag Chana. Luella David. Dennis Deary. Aliana Dela Cruz. Lauren Dela Cruz. Ada Domingo. Bishoy Ibrahim. Aaliyah Fernando. Ralph Ferrer. Jeremy Garcia. Nicola Gerardis. Ludold Go. Dominique Greppo. Dominique Habil. Alyssa Hallett. We have a few Year 10s, just like Year 9s, so can we please congratulate our Principal Award winners, part one of Year 10. Georgine Hippolito. Patrick Iskander. Arav Karen. Jade Kemba. Shania Lal. Anna Magali. Chanel McAnulty. Matthew Medinsky. Nikshay Nand. Erica Padilla. Diana Park. Max Preet. Hale Roy. ABL Santos. Yashika Sharma. Dishav Singh. V. Tong. Anna Vayakakala. Danny Yazbek. Please congratulate our Year 10 Principal Award winners. We would now like to acknowledge students who have received their second Principal's Award. From Year 9, Eulayla Barrett. So these students receive a Principal's Awards pin. Emma Crosa. The next student receives two Principal's Awards today, so a plaque as well as a pin. Alexis Romina. In Year 10, Bella Aiton. Ferdinand Cordoba. Caitlin De La Cruz. Katrina Foneste. Jordan Gutierrez. Charlize Kenny. Jackson Cyber. Please congratulate our students who have received two Principal's Awards. And as Dr. Pinnor announced earlier, we do have the first time in St Andrew's history a student who receives their third Principal's Award. And today he receives his second and third Principal's Award, so he will be receiving two pins. Please congratulate, from Year 10, Jav Kalangayo. And we encourage students that have received a Principal's Award pin to wear them on their uniform with pride daily. Please congratulate all our Principal Award winners and Dr. Pinnor. Thank you.
Could I please ask Mr. Dewar, Literacy and Special Projects Coordinator, to announce the Writing Award and Ms. Edwards, Leader of Learning English, to present the award.
Good morning, everyone. Every day, students are writing across the school. Some students choose to enter writing competitions, others are shy and choose not to do so. Yet no matter where the writing takes place, teachers are looking for examples that exemplify the strengths of students in their classrooms. Good writing is not simply about the school year you are in or the grades or the win. It is about communication. It's about how we apply empathy, draw emotions from readers, affect an audience we may never see or meet. Writing is what frames our humanity. It is an expression of the strengths God has endowed us with. The winner of this award does not need to win the most or write the most. They simply need to demonstrate an exemplary ability to engage their audience and draw us into their work. As such, this award is not dependent on year group, but on ability and talent. This year's winner of the St. Andrews Writing Award has repeatedly demonstrated this writing in both fiction and non-fiction. And it is my pleasure to announce the 2021 winner of the St. Andrews Writing Award is Eulalia Barrett in Year 9.
Could I please ask Group B award recipients to line up? Could I ask Mrs. Kamal, visual arts teacher, to present the following award? Visual arts has continued to offer many opportunities for students across the college to join into co-curricular and visual arts challenges. This year, the following student has received a gold medal award for being selected as a finalist and the runner-up in their section for the Young Australian Arts Award competition. The medal is awarded to Antonio Gregora. The following awards are first in course recipients and second and third. These are awards to the students with the highest achievement in each subject across the entire year. I now invite Ms. Simmons, Leader of Learning Wellbeing Year 7, to announce the awards, and Mr. Nick Thrum, Assistant Principal Students, to present these awards, assisted by Mr. Lees, Assistant Leader of Learning, Hissy.
It is an honour to announce the first, second and third place recipients in each course for Year 7. Students will be announced in alphabetical order. Congratulations to the following students. Joaquin Bagayas, the third place in mathematics. Catherine Biginski, first place in visual arts, second place in history, geography, and religion, third place in science. Rihanna Bartlett, first place in music and technologies, third place in English. Anna Donyakovich, third place in religion. Crystal Espino, third place in religion. Sorry, in visual arts, apologies. Claudia Fuimaono, second place in music, third place in PDHPE. Joey Gaddis, first place in mathematics, history and geography, second place in science. Nicole Gassendo, second place in visual arts. Philip Park, first place in science, second place in mathematics, third place in technologies. Ashia Sahiba, first place in science, second place in English. Michaela Sibukau, first place in English, second place in PDHP. And Samantha Xavier, first place in PDHP and religion, second place in technologies, third place in mathematics, history, geography, and music. I now invite Miss Blackwell, Leader of Learning Wellbeing for Year 8, to announce the Year 8 Awards. I invite Mr. Camilleri, Leader of Learning Hizzy, to present these awards, assisted by Mr. Kolek, Assistant Leader of Learning English. Before we continue with our place recipients, can I ask Group C to line up, please?
It's an honour to announce the first, second and third place recipients and each course for Year 8. Congratulations to the following students. Miyakura Bella, third in Japanese. Matilda Anameki, first in History and Geography. Alicia Barrett, first in PDHPE, second in music, third in history, and third in geography. Yabella De La Cruz, third in visual arts, and third in music. Sathwani Edasingh, first in English, first in science, first in religion, first in Japanese, and first in music. Maxine Gazilva, second in English. Priscilla Kubrick, third in religion. Rachel Laycock, first in technologies, first in drama, third in English, third in science, and third in mathematics. Lorraine Legog, first in visual arts and the recipient of the Nina Sevic Trophy in Art, second in technologies. Alexandra Oleksi Nazagang, second in mathematics, second in science, second in PDHPE, and third in technologies. Charlene San Pedro, second in Japanese. Yusuf Tenos, first in mathematics. Yelena Wong, second in history, second in geography, and second in visual arts. Phoebe Jewlett, third in PDHPE. Adit Rawal as well. I'm so sorry. And second place in religion.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Congratulations to all Year 8s. I now invite Mrs. Akagamanu, Leader of Learning Wellbeing Year 9, to announce the Year 9 Place Awards, and Mrs. De Guzman, Leader of Learning Mathematics, to present these awards, assisted by Mrs. Dezira, Senior PDHPE Leader of Learning.
It is an honour to announce the first, second and third place recipients in each course for Year 9. Congratulations to the following students. Anthony Ashillo, third place in PASS and Industrial Timber. Kate Astillo, second place in Visual Arts and Japanese. Eulayla Barrett, first place in PDHPE and Food Technology, third place in Science, History, English and Commerce. Yeah. Alana Bautista, first place in Industrial Technology and Multimedia. Nicole Cabale, first place in Drama. Janelle Kalingaya, second place in Drama. Ella Kalua, first place in English and Child Studies, third place in Stage 5 Accelerated Mathematics. Emma Croza, first place in History, Geography, Japanese and Music, second place in English. Jazz Delapad, first place in Japanese. Jeremy Delfino, second place in Science, third place in PDHPE and English. Marco Domingo, third place in Drama. Daniel Hurlston, second place in 5.1 Mathematics. Cooper Eisen, first place in Commerce, second place in History, Geography, 5.3 Mathematics, Industrial Technology and Multimedia. James Comm, second place in iSTEM. Kyan Langdrian, third place in Food Technology. Jade Lamino, first place in Science, third place in 5.3 Mathematics. Jelaine Magageya, third place in Music. Athu Majok, first place in Visual Arts. Tyler Mates, third place in 5.1 Mathematics. Ishwinder Najjar, first place in iSTEM, second place in Religion. Before we proceed to the next award, can the recipients from Group D please line up? Saran Papazian, second place in 5.2 Mathematics. Monarch Patel, first place in 5.3 Mathematics, third place in iSTEM. Akshita Rabadia, third place in Child Studies. Mahua Rekha, second place in Commerce. AJ Brentoy, second place in Information Software Technology. Jeremy Sabadin, second place in Food Technology. Arona Sangnalang, second place in Child Studies. Angelo Sayers, third place in information software technology. Antonio Taggart, first place in 5.1 mathematics. Yatin Tiwari, first place in information software technology. Patricia Tuazon, second place in Stage 5 Accelerated Mathematics and Music, third place in Child Studies. Rain Tui, first place in PASS, Industrial Technology Timber, 5.2 Mathematics, and third place in Religion. Dominic Watson, first place in Religion, second place in PDHPE, third place in Industrial Technology and Multimedia. Sinali Warasinghe, first place in Stage 5 Accelerated Mathematics. A huge congratulations to the Year 9 students. I now invite Mr. Frankham, Leader of Learning for Wellbeing Year 10, to announce the Year 10 awards, and Mrs. Carlos, Assistant Leader of Learning Technologies, to present the following awards, assisted by Mr. Chiapetta, Leader of Learning Music and Performance. Thank you.
It's an honour to announce the first, second and third place recipients in each course for Year 10. Congratulations to the following students. Ava Ali, second place Investigating Science and Visual Arts. Alessandra Bova, second place in PASS, third place in Geography Elective. Holly Brazier, third place in 5.1 Mathematics. Carly Burrell, third place in Japanese. Luella David, third place in 5.2 Mathematics. Caitlin Dela Cruz, third place in Religion. Ada Domingo, second place in Commerce and Music. Nicola Gerardis, first place in Food Technology. Dominique Greppo, first place in Music. Ayush Goyal, first place in Advanced Mathematics, Physics and Commerce, second place in History, second place in Geography, and third place in PDHPE. Bishoy Ibrahim, first place in History, Geography, and Science. It's all. Isabella Espinita, second place in Geography Elective. Katrina Forneste, second place in Japanese, third place in Science. Jeremy Garcia, first place in 5.2 Mathematics. Neve Healy, third place in Science. Bianca Infante, third place in Commerce. Jade Kemba, second place in Drama. Shania Lal, second place in Religion and Food Technology, third place in History, Geography and English. Nikshay Nan, second place in 5.3 Mathematics, Information Processes and Technology, and third place in iSTEM. Before we proceed with our next recipients, could I ask Group E students to line up? Hannah Johnson, first place in pass. Max Preet, third place in music. Teresia Pawadi, first place in visual arts and Japanese, second place in 5.3 mathematics. ABL Santos, first place in information processes and technology, and third place in advanced mathematics. Yashika Sharma, first place in geography elective, second place in PDHPE. Cooper Shield, second place in 5.2 mathematics and third place in PASS. Mark Stowell, second place in industrial technology timber. Sabrina Thomas, third place in industrial technology timber. Anna Vaio-Kakala, first place in English, first place in PDHPE, third place in 5.3 mathematics. Danny Yazbek, first place in 5.3 mathematics and second place in science. I now invite Ms. Pett, Leader of Learning Wellbeing for Year 11, to announce the Year 11 awards, and Mr. Robertson, Leader of Learning Technologies, to present the following awards, assisted by Ms. Flahan, Assistant Leader of Learning Science.
It is an honour to announce the first, second and third place in each course for Year 11. Congratulations to the following students. Angela Abushea, first place in Studies of Religion 1, first place Modern History, second place Biology, third place Chemistry. Jonathan Buttigieg, third place Biology, Earth and Environmental Studies. Mark Kabita, second place English Standard. Caitlin Kalima, second place Society and Culture, Industrial Technology, third place Geography. Mark Carpio, first place Japanese Continuous. Alwyn Chadha, first place Vet Business Services. Crystal Chambers, second place Vet Fitness. Melvin David, first place Vet IDT. Chugut Deng, first place Studies of Religion 2. Andre Dera, first place Sports, Lifestyle and Recreation. Damon Devine, second place Vet Construction. Marcus Iskander, third place Vet Construction. Wasim Farah, first place Economics and Legal Studies, third place Advanced English. Brandon Filizzato, second place Vet IDT. Tara Flores, first place Investigating Science, second place English Extension 1. Ethan France, third place Studies of Religion 2. John Gurgis, third place Vet Business Services. Tyrone Henderson, second place Japanese Continuous. Zach Juco, second place Music. Reese Kelly, first place Standard Mathematics, second place Business Studies and Design and Technology, third place Vet Hospitality. Rana Khalil, first place Community and Family Studies and Geography. Ramya Krishnan, third place Visual Arts. Ryan Laycock, first place Earth and Environmental Studies, second place Geography. Kiara Lomibeo, first place Design and Technology, second place Engineering. Mia Lovering, first place Visual Arts, second place Vet Hospitality, third place Japanese Continuous. Janelle Lemeno, second place Ancient History. Aya Madronero, first place Biology and Chemistry, second place Physics and Mathematics Extension 1. Monica Magpeo, third place Society and Culture. Abigail Marquez, first place Music. Jacob McLaughlin, first place Vet Hospitality. Eric Modafari, first place Vet Construction. Please congratulate our first lot of Year 11 winners. Thank you, Year 11, Part 1. Asta Mukra, third place Design and Technology. Miguel Nagwit, third place Standard Mathematics. Marcus Nicholas, second place Chemistry, Advanced Mathematics, Investigating Science and Studies of Religion 1, third place Industrial Technology and English Standard. Hayley O'Connor, first place Society and Culture, English Extension 1 and Business Studies, second place Modern History. Joanna Owusu, second place Community and Family Studies, Studies of Religion 2. Aditi Powell, second place Legal Studies and English Advanced, third place Economics and English Extension 1. Aaron Pelagio, third place PDHPE. Maddox Panaligan, third place Music. Crystal Fung, first place Advanced English, second place Visual Arts, third place Modern History. Michael Salama, third place Vet Fitness. Aaron Sabio, first place Engineering and Standard English, third place Physics. Rafter Santos, third place Vet IDT. Mitchell Sturton, first place English Studies, second place Catholic Studies. Nicole Suarez, third place Ancient History. Malcolm Tsai, second place Economics and Information Processes and Technology. Luigi Taniegra, second place PDHPE. Hayley Targarona, third place Sports, Lifestyle and Recreation. Chelsea Yudushku, third place Business Studies. Vaughn Vareo, first place Information Processes and Technology, third place Legal Studies. Victoria Vidovich, first place PDHPE. Roslyn Wells, second place Sports, Lifestyle and Recreation. Denzel Williams, second place Earth and Environmental Studies and Standard Mathematics. Jeffrey Wong, first place Mathematics Extension 1 and third place Engineering. Jasmine Zolrick, first place Industrial Technology, third place Studies of Religion 1 and Mathematics. Congratulations to all Year 11 award recipients. I now invite Mr. Deneyev, College Sports Coordinator, to the stage to announce the Sportsman and Sportswoman of the Year Awards, and Ms. Tazira and Mr. Weaver, both Leaders of Learning PDHPE, to present these awards.
Good morning. Sportsman and Sportswoman of the Year Award is awarded to the best male and female athlete of each year. This includes results at college carnivals, being selected for school sporting teams, and progressing higher to represent at PDCCC level, at New South Wales CC level, New South Wales All School, and sometimes even international level. Sportsman of the Year for Year 7, Jet Crook, who is away today. For Year 8, Daniel Coco. For Year 9, Aponza Antwi. For Year 10, Hezekiah Mayo. For Year 11, Andre Dara. Please congratulate our Sportsman of the Year for 2021. Our Sportswoman of the Year for Year 7, Brianna Brown. For Year 8, Janina Espino. For Year 9, Isabella Narayan. For Year 10, Bianca Infante. For Year 11, Hayley Tarangarona. I now invite the Year 10 Sportsman and Sportswoman of Year 10 to the stage to receive combined Sportswoman and Sportsman Perpetual Trophy. Could you please congratulate our Sportswoman of the Year and our Year 10 Sports Captains. Bianca, may you stay on the stage, please. This next award is the New South Wales CCC Blue Award. This is an annual award that acknowledges the top students of New South Wales Catholic schools who have achieved an exceptional level in their chosen sport. In 2021, Bianca Infante from St Andrews College, Marion, was awarded a New South Wales CCC Blue for her excellence in volleyball. The following awards are now awarded for the PDCCC Blue Awards. Our college has received multiple PDCCC Blue Awards across the college. The following students received the PDCCC Award today. Bianca Infante from Year 10 for her contributions to volleyball. Kaya Maher from Year 10 for his contributions to New South Wales Rugby Union. Sione Tafea for his contributions to New South Wales CCC Rugby Union. And Marley Kozak for her contributions and achievements in diving at New South Wales CCC and New South Wales All Schools. Please congratulate our recipients of the PDCCC and New South Wales CCC Awards. Thank you.
Please ask Ms. Welch, Business Manager, to the stage to present the next award for the outstanding commitment to study. Outstanding Commitment to Study Award. This award is awarded to a student who is not necessarily at the top of at the top academically, but has shown tremendous dedication and application to their studies throughout the past year. In Year 10, this award is called the Ruben F. Scarf Award. The recipient for Outstanding Commitment to Study 2021 for Year 7 is Joseph Gaddis. And in 2021, we have two Year 7 recipients of this award. The following recipient is Catherine Baginski. The Year 8 recipient for Outstanding Commitment to Study is Alexandra Marek-Segan. Our Year 9 recipient is Emma Crosser. The Year 10 recipient receives the Ruben F. Scarf Award, and it's Alessandra Bova. Our Outstanding Commitment to Study Award for Year 11 goes to Hayley O'Connor. I now invite Mr. Frank Clark, Director of Faith, Mission and Learning, and Father Redmond to the stage to present the Outstanding School Service Award. The Outstanding School Service Award is awarded to, for Year 7, Alastair Reyes. The Service Award for Year 8 goes to Alicia Barrett. The Year 9 recipient of the Service Award goes to Joshua Samet. The Year 10 recipient of the School Service Award goes to Dorothy Enzoa. Our Year 11 recipient of the award goes to Caitlin Kalima. I now invite Ms. Kalima, Leader of Faith, Mission and Learning, to present the Most Outstanding Academic Improvement Award. The Most Outstanding Academic Improvement Award for Year 7 goes to Gauri Mattesetti. For Year 8, Timson Adain. For Year 9, Cooper Bison. Most Outstanding Academic Improvement Award for Year 10 goes to Ada Domingo. And the Improvement Award for Year 11 goes to Shagut Deng. Could I please ask Group F to line up? I now invite Ms. Healy, Assistant Principal Staff and Innovation, to the stage to present the next award. Not now. The next award is for the Best All-Rounder. The Best All-Rounder Award is presented to students who have displayed the widest range of talents through academic success, representative achievement, and service to fellow students. The Year 7 recipient of the Best All-Rounder Award goes to Anna Jerakovic. The Best All-Rounder for Year 8 is Yusuf Tanis. The Best All-Rounder for Year 9 goes to two recipients, Jeremy Delfino and Jeremy Sabadin. For Year 10, the Best All-Rounder goes to Teresia Pawadi. And the Best All-Rounder for Year 11 goes to Victoria Vidovic. Please congratulate all our Best All-Rounders. I now invite Mr. Thrum, Assistant Principal Students, and Ms. Cooper, Leader of Wellbeing, to the stage to present the next award. The Leadership Trophy Perpetual Award. The Leadership Trophy recognises the leadership of school captains. Please congratulate the recipients for the 2021 Leadership Trophy, Sabrina Thomas and Caitlin Dela Cruz. I now invite Ms. May, Careers Counsellor, to present the following award. The next award is the Macquarie University Emerging Leaders Award. This award honours students who have demonstrated exceptional commitment to studies, strong leadership qualities, and a sound contribution to their community during their Year 11 studies. Please congratulate the Macquarie University Leadership Award recipients for 2021, Shukuk Deng and Wasim Farah. I now invite Mr. Isaac, Leader of Learning Science, to the stage to present the next award. The next award is the Chifley Science and Technology Prize. The Chifley Science and Technology Prize recognises students in Year 11 who perform strongly in science, technology, engineering and mathematics STEM studies. Please congratulate the Chifley Science and Technology Prize recipient, Aya Modranero. I now invite Captain Morrison to the stage to present the next awards and to address our gathering. Captain Terry Morrison is a 1990 graduate of our college, then John Paul II Senior High School. He joined the Royal Australian Navy straight after school and has now completed 31 years, the majority of which was serving at sea and on operations. He has been the commanding officer of patrol boats, a training team in Iraq, a guided missile destroyer, and has recently relinquished command of the amphibious ship HMAS Canberra. Next, Captain Morrison returns to school at the Australian War College in Canberra, where he will attend the Defence and Strategic Studies course. He's married to Marity, who is also a 1990 graduate of our college.
College Principal, Dr. Canal, College Leadership Team, teachers, parents and friends, and of course the student body of St Andrews College. First of all, I'll take the advice from the Pope. I think I'll try and be brief. I'll not be afraid to human and make mistakes. Maybe a little bit funny, and I definitely won't blame the Holy Spirit for getting lost on my way to my old school. It's a great honour to be back here in St Andrews College. As having graduated in 1990, about this time of the year, and then I joined the military in January the 22nd, 1991. And having now completed 30 odd years across all these different areas, I'm very happy to be back here to this college where it all began. And before I talk about the ADF Long Tan Awards, I want to have a message to the student body. So when I was sitting here, like you, I had a dream, and my dream was to serve in the military, serve our nation, and to do what I can to protect us and our country. But as it is, there's lots of things you've got to do to achieve that. I didn't know if I had the physical capability, the intellect, and a number of other things, so I had some doubt, as you may have in yourself. But having completed 31 years now, I can categorically say that it didn't matter how good I was here. What mattered was is how I set goals and worked towards those goals day after day throughout that 30 years to achieve them, and by far exceeding my goals. So to all of you out there, I'd say if you're in doubt whether you're going to do that, be able to achieve your dreams or what you want to do, set those goals high and then put in place some systems to enable you to work towards achieving those goals. So the ADF, Australian Defence Force Long Tan Awards, is named after the Battle of Long Tan, which occurred in Vietnam in August 1966. And it was only 3 months after our base was established in Nui Dat, the Australian base, and we were coming under incursions and attacks throughout that period. And to defeat that, or trying to work out where those attacks were, 6RAR did patrols in the local area. And on one day, Delta Company, a company of only 108 men, were on patrol, and they encountered the North Vietnamese soldiers, estimated between 1,000 to 2,000. They were outnumbered more than 10 to 1, and it took a lot of effort for them to overcome that and to fight their way out of that problem. They did this through coordinating with assistance from other elements of 6RAR, the Australian and the US artillery, and ammunition resupply from the Air Force's helicopters. And during the battle, they demonstrated courage, loyalty, commitment to one another, leadership, innovation, and critical thinking. And it's those same qualities today that has been identified in two students in your college. And I'll now hand over to Mrs. De Camps to explain those awards.
The ADF Future Innovators Award recognises students in Year 10 who have demonstrated motivation and innovation in the areas of STEM, so that's science, technology, engineering and mathematics, within their school, who display strong personal ethical values such as doing one's best. The recipient of this award is Danny Yazbek.
Thank you.
Long 10 Award for Leadership and Teamwork. Recognises students who demonstrate leadership and teamwork within both the school and the broader community. It also recognises students who display strong values, such as doing one's best, respect for others and mateship, that are integral to Australian society. Please congratulate the Long 10 Award recipient, Leadership and Team recipient for 2021, Sabrina Thomas. Thank you, Captain Morrison. Could I please ask Group G award recipients to take their places? Could I also ask Ms. Thompson, Leader of Learning Mathematics, to present the following award? The next award is the Rotary Award for Citizenship, which recognises school and community involvement. It is an award for the Year 10 student considered by peers and teachers as having been the best citizen. Please congratulate the Rotary Award recipient for 2021, Bianca Infante. Our next awards are for academic excellence. Academic excellence awards are awarded to the students in each year with outstanding academic achievement across subject areas. For years 7, 8, 9 and 10, this is calculated across their entire year's performance. In year 11, it is calculated using an ATAR model. The top three students in each year are acknowledged, with the highest placed student in each year receiving the Ducks Award. Could I please ask Dr. Knorr to the stage to present the following awards? Our Year 7 2021 Academic Excellence Awards will be presented in alphabetical order. First, we have Catherine Baginski in Year 7. Rihanna Bartlett. Nicole Gassendo. Joseph Gaddis. Monica Luong. Philip Park. Katerina Pawadi. Jalen Rummers, Asha Sahiba, Layla Sanchez, Michaela Subikayo, Tara Smith, Samantha Xavier, first we will acknowledge our overall third place recipients in Year 7, Catherine Baginski. Rihanna Bartlett, Philip Park. And we have two recipients of the Ducks Award in Year 7 this year. Our first is Nicole Gassendo. And Samantha Xavier. Our Academic Excellence Awards in Year 8. Again, they're in alphabetical order. Matilda Adamechi. Alicia Barrett. Jobella Dela Cruz. Daniel Birchmore. Maxine Gasilva. Nigel Kranaratna. Alexandra Marasigan. Gary Singh. Yusuf Tanis. Angelina Wong. This year we have 5 Ducks Awards in Year 8. So in alphabetical order, we have Daniel Birchmore, Maxine Gasilva, Alexandra Marasigan, Yusuf Tanis, Angelina Wong. Please congratulate our Ducks Award recipients. Excellence Awards go to Year 9. So in alphabetical order, we have Yolala Barrett, Daniela Kalura. Jeremy DeFino. Kyan Lindrigan. James Conn. Abe Negra. Ishwinder Nija. Siram Papadzian. Raina Rayo. Rain Tui. Dominic Watson. In year 9 in 2021, we have two second place recipients, James Conn Dominique Watson. Yeah. Our Ducks of Year 9 is Yalela Barrett. Academic Excellence Awards for Year 10, in alphabetical order, Ava Alley. Ada Domingo. Ludonald Go. Ayush Gael. Neve Healy. Bianca Infante. Shania Lal. Nick Shay Nand. Jacob Nath, Tricia Pawadi, Abiel Santos, Yashika Sharma, Anna Vayakakala. This year in Year 10, we have multiple placed recipients in second and third. First of all, our overall third place in Year 10 goes to Neve Healy. Bianca Infante. Jacob Nath. Anovea Kakala. Overall second place in Year 10 goes to Ava Ali. Teresia Pawadi. And Yashika Sharma. Our ducks of Year 10 is Ayush Goyal. Award recipients for Year 11 in alphabetical order: Angela Abachea, Caitlin Kalima, Wasim Farah, Rana Khalil, Aya Medranero, Marcus Nicholas, Paley O'Connor, Crystal Fung, Victoria Vidovich, and Vaughan Vareo. Overall, third place in Year 11 goes to Marcus Nicholas. Overall, second place in Year 11 goes to Wasim Farah. Our ducks of Year 11 goes to Hayley O'Connor. Our final award is the St Andrew's Ambassador Award. St Andrew's was the first to respond to Jesus' call to discipleship. He was a person who influenced others, he was a leader, he could change things for the better, and he was of outstanding character, virtue and ability. The recipients of this award personify the values we as a community endorse and the values to which we aspire. As St Andrew's, the St Andrew's College Ambassador Award, along with the St Andrews Award in Year 12, is the highest award of the college. The St Andrews Ambassador Award for Year 7 goes to Oliver Brez. Our Year 8 St Andrews Ambassador Award goes to Suwanthi Edrisingh. The St Andrews Ambassador Award for Year 9 goes to Yelena Barrett. The St Andrews Ambassador Award for Year 10 goes to Sabrina Thomas. And the St Andrews Ambassador Award for Year 11 goes to Wasim Farah. Our Year 7 to 11 awards ceremony. Please thank all award recipients again. I would also like to thank parents for celebrating this occasion with your child and our school community. Students, for all of your hard work and determination towards achievement, and staff for their unending dedication and support for student learning. Have a safe and wonderful Christmas and New Year, and God bless. Could I please ask all parents to leave the hall for our light refreshments in the Learning Centre. Students, I would ask you to remain for a moment.